Hello and the greetings from Iceland, but it's been over a year now since the Geldingadalir eruption started, so it's a good time to speculate about the future and to do the usual seismic unrest tour to see what's normal and what's not under my country. But first, let's chew on the so-called Icelandic spring. The sheep just got out, where they enjoy the sun just as much as the rest of us, as the snow is melting away after a long and dark Icelandic winter. Some prefer to call images like this with the melting snow a sign of global warming, but for me this is more of a local bummer, since the spring is the most boring time of year when it comes to photography, or the yellow season as I call it. And yes, we all miss this. The red stuff that rescued last spring for us. But what about the future? That was to be the only subject of today's video, or until I made a last minute check, only to find out that we have a new and rather strong earthquake swarm in Grindavik now. So I'm starting there, but this location we are looking at now is no surprise. But this was shot a year ago from the northernmost part of town, and the earthquake location is exactly here, or just by this old volcano. That is actually one of the places where we believed that an eruption could take place last year. And just across the highway, few hundred meters away from this volcano, we have Mount Thorbjörn, where everything started. We can actually say that the Geldingadalir eruption started there, or when we had this land uplift there in January 2021. So we are back to square one in a way. But the unrest in 2021 that started under Mount Thorbjörn moved to east from there and made a stopover by this nasty old fissure I have often mentioned before. And today's earthquakes are around here, and the mountain, yet another name for you, Siglingafell. That's the place that's bothering us today. But back to history, the unrest that started under Mount Thorbjörn and moved east made a stopover here. And the story would then continue under Mount Keilir, from where we could watch the magma intrusion almost live move south until it came up in Geldingadalir. And the unrest near Grindavik faded out little by little, but never fully. Things really never got back to normal. And looking at the bigger picture, our experts told us back then that when all this started, that this was marking the beginning of a chapter that might plague us for the next 200 years. But lately, there has simply been very little information out there, except for this one interview, where that theory about this long chapter of unrest was actually called into question by the same experts that only a year ago assumed that the Geldingadalir eruption was just the first event of many to come. And this came as a surprise to me, mostly due to how things have been developing for the last months. But this is how the earthquake map looks for the first 3 months of 2022, not including today's earthquakes. And for comparison, let's take a look at the same period in 2018 and then 2019. But that is more and less the norm, although it is hard to define some kind of norm when it comes to the geology of Iceland. But then we got 2020 and 2021. And note that I'm just showing you the first 3 months of the year, so this is not very scientific. But 2022 is still far away from the norm, even though things have obviously cooled down a bit. But we might just as well see new earthquakes by the hundreds in the next days, as it looks now. But more about that later. The biggest remaining question is, of course, was the Geldingadalir eruption just an isolated event? Or does Mother Nature have something more in the pipes for us? But shortly after the new year, I mentioned that the next cycle might start in 2-3 months, and not necessarily end up with an eruption. But in fact, I was just predicting that we might see the pattern from October repeat itself, or a pattern of strong unrest, or a cycle lasting for 2-3 months where Mother Nature takes a deep breath, and then a chapter of unrest that might just as well end up with an eruption or a large earthquake, magnitude 5 plus. Are we looking at new seismic cycle starting today? So let's take a look at the last 30 days And then we get a picture like this. And let's see if it can tell us something. We start on the westernmost part of the peninsula, or offshore, where we get eruptions every 100 years or so, on average. Nothing new there, just constant unrest that we are not used to see around there. Unrest that has been going on for at least 16 months now. But as we move into Grindavik, we notice this recent activity undermount Thorbjörn, just by town. That earthquake swarm seems to be moving east now, just like last year. But before we dive into that, I want to mention that it is noticeable that we don't see that many earthquakes by the Geldingadalir volcano now. The magma intrusion from last December did obviously solidify. But as we move closer to the enormous Krýsuvík volcanic system that stretches all the way into the capital, we can see a path of earthquakes leading to there from Mount Keilir, actually looking very similar as the magma intrusion that traveled from Mount Keilir to Geldingadalir. But our experts have not confirmed any magma intrusion there. Tension changes in the region is a word they use. But land uplift was however detected around here or further south like 6 months ago. And what we are getting now is just little bits and pieces of information. Like I've not heard anything from our scientists about the status by Mount Thorbjörn recently. Like is land still rising there or what? But the ongoing earthquake swarm might change that. But it's Sunday, so the press might allow our experts to enjoy the weekend before they start to ask questions. But I am, however, a bit frustrated due to lack of information. But I might as well blame it on the media since it's their job to do the follow-up. After all, we are talking about land uplift near our capital. But let's see what I can do about that later on. I even got the idea to have a new series on my channel called Getting Drunk with a Geologist and see if I can get some of those experts drunk and chill down so they would really tell me what they think. Not the careful media version. It's no use there. But it is a bit rude method that comes with hangovers, so I have not dared to try it yet. And as for me, this is all about reliable information from people who know what they are talking about. But to make them willing to talk, that's the hard part. And since this video was more or less prepared on Saturday, before the ongoing Sunday events in Grindavik, I am going to take you all the way up to the north by the plate boundaries and tell you the overall status here in Iceland and finish today's tour in Grindavik again. And first I'm mentioning the earthquakes by Langjökull Glacier that I have covered in a separate video a while ago, or this strange location that our experts can't explain fully, and this is how it looks for the past 3 months, or this very nice cluster of earthquakes that still remain a mystery. I actually wish that I had some drone footage from there to show you the features of the landscape, but I'm gonna wait for the green colors, since it seems as the earthquake swarm is fading out. So let's move to the Katla volcano and the Hekla volcano. I can't say we have any surprises there this time. I don't expect Katla to do anything in the near future. She sends us little teasers every now and then, just to tell us that she's still there. But Hekla remains the wild card in my mind for 2022, or this ticking time bomb that can go off with a very short notice. And I've already shown you all of my little collection of Hekla photos too often. So this is also one of the places that I really need to visit with a drone. And what makes geology so fascinating for me is of course the fact that a photo tour there today might just as well end up in the history books tomorrow if the landscape starts to change once again. So Hekla is one of the top 5 locations I have to visit next summer. And there I need to take a carefully planned flyover, so I have all angles of the mountain on stock. But the next destination of today won't be as easy to get to, or Vatnajökull Glacier, where we have Iceland's most active volcano Grímsvötn, just by the Bárðarbunga hotspot. Things are still hectic up there, and in the case of Grímsvötn, we should hope for small eruptions on a regular basis, because we know what this system is capable of. And just by we have Bárðarbunga that seems to be reloading since the 2014 eruption, judging from the earthquakes. And we still get larger earthquakes than 3 every month or so. but I don't bother to mention them especially, and I can't say that anything new is happening up there now. But as we move further north to Askja Volcano, where the land has risen by 20 centimeters since August last year, or according to the last reliable report. But we have to keep in mind that the winter and the cold in the highlands is a problem, often leaving the instruments up there disconnected for a long period. And that's because solar energy and Iceland is just as black humor as the Icelandic spring. So when our experts will be able to go up there again, we might get more accurate report of what's really happening there. I, however, can't say that I see any changes in earthquake pattern by Askja. It's always plenty of them, and it's a process that's been going on for a long time, especially by a place called Upptippingar, just a few miles north from Askja. So Mother Earth has been preparing something up there for a long time now, and we might have to wait for years, even decades, until something big happens. And somehow I doubt that it's gonna be this year, although it's not for me to tell. But despite of that, Askja is one of the places I plan to visit next summer, because this is a remarkable landscape up there, and I do need plenty of drone footage by hand when and if something happens. But to get up there, that won't happen until June. So we move further north, and on the way up to the north coast, we see increased earthquake activity by Krafla Volcano and Lake Mývatn. And I tend to ask myself if those movements have something to do with the Askja unrest. And when we get all the way up north to the Tjörnes fracture zone offshore, we see huge activity, but that is nothing new. That is where we expect a large earthquake to take place anytime, up to magnitude 7. But we do also get earthquakes around 5 there every now and then, and seismic chapters that last for weeks, the last one in 2020. So it would not surprise me if we would get some news from there soon. But as for the large earthquake that hangs over us, we might have to wait longer. But back to Grindavik. My overall opinion about what to expect in 2022 hasn't changed, even though the year started slowly. Things are not back to the abnormal Icelandic norm, and Mother Nature has something more than the pipes for us. I'm very sure about that. Mount Siglingafell, where the earthquakes are now today, was only 14 months ago called Iceland's most dangerous volcano by one of our experts. Not due to its size, but due to the proximity to the fishery town Grindavik, the Blue Lagoon, and the power plant. This is absolutely the worst place to get an eruption of any size. Simple as that. So, I am watching this closely, and I might drive south to the peninsula and Reykjavik tomorrow. I have to leave my Nikon to be repaired in Reykjavik, since the shutter just broke down shortly after this time-lapse the other day. But the good news is that I need more or less only drone footage from Grindavik now, so I can handle some time without my Nikon. But it is so important for me to have a large photo stock covering all angles to grab and use whenever I need. And I have to admit that my channel was unusually quiet lately, but other work was keeping me busy for a while. I do, however, admit that I would have preferred more traffic on my channel after the eruption came to an end, especially since I have been creating a lot of tourism-related content for last months, but it's been taking me a bit longer time than I hoped for to get that part of my channel going. But I knew it all along that the volcano traffic here will always be as unstable as an Icelandic volcano. That's just how it is. But I am only grateful for the responses if the ongoing earthquake swarm seems to be turning into something nasty. But it doesn't look so in the moment though. It looks now like a strong spike that won't necessarily continue. But I have to say that I never doubted that the Geldingadalir eruption was only the beginning of something more. And we should be very grateful, since we were so extremely lucky about that location. So lucky that, in fact, it will be hard to beat that when it comes to the next Chapter. And as for the longer future of Grindavik, if we are indeed looking at up to 200 years of unrest, it doesn't look good for the town, for sure. But more about that later, when I have the drone footage that I need to cover that better, lava paths and such. But we remain hopeful, of course. And there are evacuation plans ready now, plans that didn't exist a year ago. So at least we can say we are way better prepared than last year. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.